Namaste. In this learning dialogue, we will study about synthesis of propranolol and synthesis of clonidine. So let us begin with synthesis of propranolol, which is synthesized starting with 1-naphthol. 1-naphthol on reaction with potassium hydroxide gives potassium salt of naphthol, naphthalate, which reacts with epichlorohydrin. The naphthoxy anion attack on the carbon atom consisting chlorine substituent to give the ether of chlorohydrin, which then react with propanamine. The nitrogen will attack on the carbon, which is electron deficient, to open the ring and obtain the desired compound, that is propranolol. So pause the video, think about the role of reagents like potassium hydroxide, isopropylamine in the synthesis of propranolol, and write down in your course journal. So to summarize, the role of KOH is to generate the naphthoxy ion, which is a good nucleophile that will attack on the electron deficient carbon of epichlorohydrin. Role of propanamine, the primary nitrogen being electron rich, will act as a nucleophile which will attack on the electron deficient carbon of this epoxide ring, and it will give the racemic form of propranolol. The next is synthesis of clonidine. Clonidine is synthesized starting with 2,6-dichloroaniline, which is allowed to react with the 2-methylthioimidazole. This intermediate is obtained from imidazole leading 2-thione, which upon methylation with methyl iodide gives 2-methylthioimidazole. The electron rich amine group will attack on this electron deficient carbon to give the desired compound clonidine. So pause the video and think about the role of two six dichloroaniline in synthesis of clonidine and write down in your course journal. So the role of 2,6-dichloroaniline is the amino function act as a good nucleophile which will attack on the electron deficient carbon present in 2-methylthioimidazole to give the desired compound, that is clonidine. So clonidine is obtained by reaction of 2,6-dichloroaniline with 2-methylthioimidazole in one step. Thank you.